Good evening students. In this video, we will discuss the classifications of collides on the basis of the type of particles of dispersed phase. Means nature of the particles of dispersed phase. In last two video, you have seen the classifications on the basis of the physical state of dispersed phase and dispersion medium, and classifications on the basis of the nature of interactions between the dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Okay, today we will discuss classification on the basis of the type of particles of dispersed phase. There are three types of collides. One is called multimolecular collide, the second is macromolecular collide, and third one is associated collide. Okay, first we are going to discuss multimolecular collide. ये multimolecular collide क्या है? देखो ना, इसमें क्या होता है? When we dissolve the dispersed phase in dispersion medium, the smaller particles of the dispersed phase combine to form a large particle having colloidal dimensions. For example, if you take gold salt. Means colloidal solutions of gold. क्या होता है? When the gold is dispersed in a solvent in dispersion medium, what will happen? The smaller gold atoms having very very small size less than 1 nanometer will combine to form a particles having colloidal phase. Means they combine to form colloidal particles. Therefore, in gold salts, gold is called multimolecular collide because this collide is formed by combinations of the smaller atoms, aggregation of the smaller atoms of gold. Similarly, if you take sulfur salt, what will happen in case of sulfur salt? Sulfur salt mein kya hoga? When sulfur is dispersed in a particular solvent, the smaller sulfur molecule, S8 molecule, will combine with each other. Will combine with each other to form what? A colloidal particles of sulfur. So the sulfur dispersed in solvent is known as multimolecular collide, and the such colloidal solution is known as multimolecular colloidal solution. So when on dispersion of a substance, means dispersed phase, in dispersion medium, a large number of atoms or smaller molecule of the substance combine or aggregate to form species having colloidal dimension or colloidal range, means 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer. The species thus formed are called multimolecular collide. This type of collide is known as multimolecular collide. Like in gold salt, the colloidal particles of gold is known as multimolecular collide. In sulfur salt, colloidal particles of sulfur are known as multimolecular collide, and the solution is known as multimolecular colloidal solutions. Is it clear? Okay, now come to the next. The next one is macromolecular collide. इसमें नाम था मल्टीमॉलिक्यूलर क्योंकि छोटा छोटा मिलकर के बना रहा था एक कोलाइडल पार्टिकल एटम्स और मॉलिक्यूल्स में. मैक्रो मतलब क्या हुआ? लार्ज. मींस इन दिस केस द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ डिस्पर्स्ड फेज आर वेरी लार्ज एंड दे हैव ऑलरेडी कोलाइडल डायमेंशंस व्हेन दे डिस्पर्स्ड इन वाटर और एनी अदर सुटेबल डिस्पर्सन मीडियम. They have already colloidal dimensions, right? Means in macromolecular collide, in this type of collide, colloidal particles are themselves a large molecule having already colloidal dimensions, right? जैसे मान लो हम लेते हैं प्रोटीन. प्रोटीन को किसी में डिस्पर्स करेंगे तो प्रोटीन का जो मॉलिक्यूल्स है उसका साइज पहले से ही कितना होगा? कोलाइडल पार्टिकल्स के साइज के बराबर होगा, 1 नैनोमीटर टू 1000 नैनोमीटर. ठीक है ना? यहाँ पे कॉम्बिनेशन से नहीं बन रहा है. ऑलरेडी द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द डिस्पर्स्ड फेज when they are dispersed in dispersion medium, the particles of dispersed phase having these dimensions. Okay, so in macromolecular collides, macromolecular means polymers, like polymers having big molecule. Okay, so in this case, on dispersion of the dispersed phase in dispersion medium, the particles of the dispersed phase having already collider dimensions. Okay, so we can say when certain substances, especially having big sized molecule, और ये किसमें होगा? Polymers में, macromolecules में, उसका molecules का size क्या होता है? बड़ा होता है. Dissolved in a suitable solvent, dispersion medium, they form solution in which the molecules of the dispersed phase, means the substance, have size in the colloidal range. Okay. And the example is natural and synthetic polymers. When any natural or synthetic polymers are dispersed in a suitable solvent, the colloidal particles are called macromolecular colloids, because these colloidal particles are very large in size, having already molecular dimension equal to colloidal dimension, means the size of the molecule lies between 1 nanometer and 1000 nanometer. Okay, one more thing, in case of the macromolecular collides, the colloidal solutions are quite stable and they resemble with the true solution in many respects. Means number of properties of macromolecular colloidal solutions is same as that of true solutions. Okay, and as these molecules have large size and have dimension comparable to those of colloidal particles, their dispersions are called macromolecular collide. Okay, I think it is clear what is multimolecular, what is macromolecular collide. Now, the third one is associated collide. What is associated collide? The third is associated collide. See, there are certain substances which behaves as a normal electrolyte at low concentration, but at high concentration, they behave like a collide. Okay, means at low concentration, their solutions are true solutions, but at high concentration, their solutions will be colloidal solutions. Okay. And such collides are known as associated collides, and the colloidal solutions are known as associated colloidal solutions. For example, if a small amount of soap is dissolved in water, you know what is soap? Soap is sodium salt of higher fatty acid, like sodium stearate. When a small amount of soap is dissolved in water, this soap will behave as a normal electrolyte. Their particles can easily pass through the parchment paper and animal medium. But if the concentration of soap is large, it is more than a certain minimum concentrations, which is known as critical mineralization concentration. So what will happen? In that case, this part will combine with each other through the hydrophobic part. There are two parts here. One is known as hydrophobic, C17S35, inert hydrocarbon part are known as hydrophobic part. Hydrophobic means water se repel karega, and this is known as hydrophilic part. Hydrophilic, water loving part. See, what will happen when a large amount of soap is dispersed in water at certain temperature? What will happen? These hydrophobic part, inert hydrocarbon part, will combine with each other. And after combination, what will you observe? An aggregated particle will be formed, associated particle will form. Okay. These associated particles are known as micelles. since its surface will be charged, negatively charged, therefore it is ionic missiles. M-I-S-C-E-L-E-S. Missiles. Okay, what is missile? What is missile? Missile may be defined as a cluster or aggregated particles formed by associated colloidal solution. Okay, so when this substance is dispersed in a particular solvent, it forms an associated molecule, and that associated molecules having colloidal dimensions. These missiles have colloidal dimensions, and therefore this particle cannot pass through the parchment paper or anything. So soap is called associated colloids. Okay, because the colloidal particles of soap is formed by the association of large number of this species. C17S35COO-I. That's why it is called associated colloid. And the colloidal particles of associated colloid is also known as missiles. Isko hum log kya bolte hain? Missiles. So the example of associated colloid is soap and detergents. Soap and detergents. Detergents. Right. So how will you define associated colloid? There are certain substances. You may write here, there are certain substances like soap and detergents. There are certain substances, okay, which behave as normal electrolyte at low concentration, but at higher concentration they behave as colloid. Colloid. Due to formation of aggregated particles. Due to formation of what? And what these aggregated particles are called? These aggregated particles are called missiles. Right? These are called missiles. Okay. So, बहुत सा substance है जिसको कम मात्रा में dissolve करोगे solvent में तो normal electrolyte की तरह behave करेगा. लेकिन जब ज्यादा amount में dissolve करोगे तो वो एक कोलाइड की तरफ काम करेगा और उसका सॉल्यूशन कैसा होगा? कोलाइडल सॉल्यूशन कहलाएगा. एंड सच कोलाइडल पार्टिकल्स आर फॉर्म्ड बाय द एग्रीगेशंस ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स. दैट्स व्हाई सच कोलाइड्स आर नोन एज एसोसिएटेड कोलाइड. फॉर एग्जांपल सोप एंड डिटर्जेंट्स आर एसोसिएटेड कोलाइड्स. एंड द एग्रीगेटेड पार्टिकल्स हैविंग द रेंज ऑफ कोलाइडल डायमेंशंस आर कॉल्ड मिसल्स. ओके, दे मे बी न्यूट्रल मिसल्स एज वेल एज ionic missiles. In case of soap, you have seen this is ionic missiles. One more thing, there are two terms here. One is known as CMC. CMC is critical missilization concentration. Critical missilization concentration. What do you mean by critical missilization concentration? Kisko bole? देखो ना, अ सब्सटेंस कैन एक्ट एज अ एसोसिएटेड कोलाइड इफ इट हैज अ कंसंट्रेशन मोर देन अ सर्टेन मिनिमम कंसंट्रेशन एंड दैट कंसंट्रेशन इज नोन एज सीएमसी क्रिटिकल मिसलाइजेशन कंसंट्रेशन. इन अदर वर्ड यू कैन से द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द सब्सटेंस इन द सॉल्यूशन एट विच a measles is formed is known as CMC, critical mislicense concentration. The formation of measles takes place above certain concentrations. That concentration is known as critical mislicense concentration. This concentration pe measles ka formation. And other is graft tempage. Graft tempage. One more thing. What is graft temperature? The formations of measles takes place above a particular temperature known as graft temperature. Okay, every measles system has specific value of CMC and graft temperature. Right? हर एक का अलग अलग होगा अपना अपना. तो दीज आर द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ कोलाइड्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ डिस्पर्स्ड फेज. आई थिंक इट इज क्लियर. ओके, थैंक यू.